Please be seated. Graduates, parents, grandparents, family members, friends, and special guests, welcome to the 2017 commencement exercises at Castlewood High School. Congratulations to you, the class of 2017, for this significant achievement. I commend each of you for your diligent and persistent efforts in reaching this milestone in your life. As a former graduate of Castlewood High School, it is my distinct pleasure to now serve as the principal of Castlewood High School. It has been a privilege and honor to have a role in the education of these young people. And I thank you, the parents, for allowing this school to be a part of their educational experience. The class of 2017 has been a remarkable class and a very competitive class academically. This is evidenced by the number enrolled in college and the significant amount of scholarship money they have been awarded this year. Every graduate seated before you has accomplished academic success. AIM scholars have excelled in academics, attendance, and behavior. Beta members have demonstrated excellence in academics and character. Honor students have finished high school with a GPA of 94 or higher. Several of the students have exceeded the standard diploma requirements by taking additional higher level classes to earn an advanced studies diploma. And approximately one-fourth of this group has earned the distinction of early scholars by meeting the rigorous demands of governor school and dual credit classes. Finally, others have taken the career and technology pathway to earn licensures and certifications in their chosen vocations. The educational process takes more than just the school. It is a cooperative effort of the school, parents, and extended family of each student. There are many people in the audience who have made sacrifices to allow the class of 2017 the opportunity to be successful today. You, the parents, are at the top of the list. The love, encouragement, discipline, time, finances, and assistance that you have shared with your children has contributed greatly to their achievement. You have celebrated their successes and encouraged them in times of disappointment. Would the parents of the class of 2017 please stand and be recognized? Another group that we cannot overlook, and perhaps the proudest of all, are those who have given their unconditional love, wisdom, moral support, and understanding when it seemed no one else could. Would the grandparents of the class of 2017 please stand and be recognized? At this time, I would like to honor some special guests who are with us to celebrate this special day with the class of 2017. When I call your name, if you would please stand and be recognized. Mr. Donnie Ramey, Chairman of the Russell County School Board. Ms. Cynthia Compton, Vice Chair of the Russell County School Board. Mr. Wayne Bostick, Russell County School Board. Mr. Charlie Collins, Russell County School Board. Mr. Jeff Cook, Russell County School Board. Mistress Linda Garrett, Russell County School Board. Mr. Alex Zakawija, Russell County School Board. Dr. Gregory Brown, Superintendent of Russell County Public Schools. Mr. Scotty Fletcher, Assistant Superintendent of Russell County Public Schools. Mr. Steve Breeding, Chairman, Russell County Board of Supervisors. Mistress Lou Ann Wallace, Russell County Board of Supervisors. Mr. David Eaton, Russell County Board of Supervisors. Russell County Sheriff's Department, we have Sheriff Steve Dye, Deputy Chief Bill Watson, Deputy and SRO Cuba Porter, Deputy Shannon Skeens, and Deputy Roy Glover. Also with us today, we have Mr. Michael Robertson, Principal of Russell County Alternative Program. Castlewood High School has a faculty and staff that is a very dedicated, hardworking group who are committed to excellence. It takes the teamwork of bus drivers, cafeteria workers, secretaries, custodians, instructional aides, and teachers to make a school work well. The staff at Castlewood High School is a very special group, and I appreciate each one of them very much. Their hard work is evidenced by the fact that Castlewood High School is fully accredited by the state of Virginia. Would the faculty and staff of Castlewood School please stand? A special thanks goes to the faculty members that have worked closely with the seniors to finalize their plans after graduation and see that everything was in order for them to meet the state graduation requirements. Would Mistress Ashley Worley and Mr. John Verderosa please stand? Another individual who has been invaluable in the everyday running of the school is the assistant principal. He has spent many hours helping supervise and support the students of this school. Would Mr. Jared Sparks please stand? At this time, the Castlewood High School Band senior members, if you would join the band. The Castlewood High School Band will now perform Castles and Kings by Bruce Pearson. Thank you. At this time, I would like to recognize the class of 2017 top 10. When I call your rank and name, please stand to be honored. 10th, Mr. Cade Steele. 9th, Ms. Allison Long. 8th, Mr. Cody Meade. 7th, Ms. Sydney Strange. 6th, Ms. Shelby Grizzle. 6th, Ms. Darla Mullins. 5th, Ms. Shelby Grizzle. Sorry, Shelby. 4th, Ms. Madison Ray. 3rd, Ms. Cameron Cook. 2nd, Ms. Savannah Robertson. Savannah, if you would please come forward and give the salutatory address.
Good afternoon, Dr. Brown, school board members, faculty and staff, parents, family, and friends, and especially you, the CHS class of 2017. I would like to start out by saying that the past couple weeks have been pretty awesome. This is probably mostly because, as seniors, not many of us have actually shown up to school. If we have, we've either been playing Uno, tie-dying with Miss Wilson, playing with Sherman, or riding the Fury 325 at Carowinds. I think we can all agree that it's been a pretty great ending to high school, but more than that, it's been a pretty great year, pretty great 12 years together. If you all will take a moment to remember back to August 2012, when we were walking the halls of Castlewood High School for the first time as high school students, I think you'll be amazed, as I am, at how much has changed. We've made new friends that have surprised us, we've lost friendships that we thought would last a lifetime, we've stayed after practice, we've come before school, we've become professional procrastinators, we've overslept, we've underslept, we've found new passions and said goodbye to old ones, and now the time has come when we will no longer wake up just to do these things all over again. If you're still remembering August 2012, like I said, you'll realize just how much things have changed since then. Our class is one that's had a lot of adjusting to do. Since eighth grade, we've been through two superintendents, four principals, lots of different coaches, and we've seen teachers leave in the middle of the school year. We watched as eighth graders, the senior class, tear down our homecoming hallway. Last year, we won the spirit stick only to have it taken away, but that's okay because we won it back this year. All of the chaos we've seen the past few years reminds me of one of my mom's favorite sayings, rejoice in the ordinary. Since our time in eighth grade, we've seen a lot of different ordinaries. From Coach Kaiser letting us walk the halls in the mornings, to Dr. Graves' PE uniforms and that song every morning on the announcements that never failed to get stuck in our heads, to Ms. Lila's hallway signs after game days and candy canes on our lockers, we've seen a lot of changes come and go through the halls of Castlewood High. We've learned to take things day by day and to face obstacles as they come. If anyone doubts this, ask about the whole obstacles thing. Ask Cody Meade about how I wrecked my go-kart into his a couple weeks ago. We both barely survived. Honestly though, our class is one that has ultimately surprised me with all we've been able to accomplish, and not just when it comes to go-karts. We're a class that has come into our own over the course of our high school career. We're a class that has finally proved that we've acquired the responsibility, the fortitude, and the motivation necessary to successfully finish high school and to move forward into whatever's next. We've certainly learned to rejoice in the ordinary, and more than that, we've learned how to face the unordinary with grace. And this perhaps is what I'm most grateful for. So to all of you, thank you. Thank you to every single member of this class who has shared equally in our victories and our losses, in our highs and our lows. To Madison, Cameron, Peyton, Cassidy, and Jill, thank you for the cabin sleepovers, the truth or dare, the zipline days, and the spontaneous trips to El Palenque. I've been so blessed to have had friends I can trust with anything and everything. And Jill, I can't wait to keep making the memories next year at Radford that we started in seventh grade. Jacob, thanks for being a person I can count on for anything. The last 2 years of high school wouldn't have been the same without you. You filled my junior and senior years with laughter, music, and a ton of wonderful memories. Who would have thought we'd have lasted past the first date when you threw open my car? And of course, I can't forget to thank all of our wonderful teachers. To all of you here that have come to school and have taught us, advised us, and mentored us in things within and things without the classroom, thank you for the time you've invested in our class. You're appreciated and we'll remember you for so much more than just the SOLs you've taught. To Ms. Crabtree, I would like for you to know that I must really like you a lot to have ended up running cross country all these years. I mean, I really must have liked you. Ms. Wilson, all I can say is that I should have taken art sooner. Thank you for giving me a first period that I actually looked forward to attending every day, along with all of the other good Christian children. Ms. Altizer, because of you, I'll always remember to think outside the box. Ashley, thanks for your card games, your daily reminders that you love us, and for literally picking me up off the floor when I needed it most. Ms. Lila, thank you for all of your support and your homemade signs in the hallways. Ms. D, the impact you've had on me is greater than I can say. Thank you for believing in me completely in everything I've done the past 2 years, from the classroom to the track. Thanks for the birthday flowers, the daily jokes, and for showing us all that teaching is so much more than just a way to get a paycheck. And Mom, it's been a privilege to have had you as my drama and forensics coach. I wish I could have started sooner, because you're far more talented and gifted than you're given credit for. And I can't wait to watch you bring home more state championships. More than being my coach, though, thanks for being my mom. Thank you and Dad both for giving me the world, and more importantly, the tools I need to change it for the better. I'll never be able to thank you all enough for all you've done for me and all you continue to do. I've never had to wonder if you all were coming to support me at a track meet or dance competition. You've come to everything I've ever done without question. You've shown me the kind of person I want to be. Skylar, you wanted me to mention you, so there, I mentioned you. No, actually, you have wisdom and strength beyond your years. On so many occasions, your generosity has made me change my way of thinking and look at things from different perspectives, and you're one of the few people I can say that truly makes me a better person every time I'm with you. I can't wait to watch you change the world, because I have absolutely no doubt that you will. Don't ever doubt how special you are to me and how much I love you. My mom and papa, I'll thank you for being the most supportive, enthusiastic, and loving grandparents I could ask for. I love you all and appreciate you more than you'll ever know. I hope I can make you proud. Speaking of making people proud, to you guys, we're gonna do just that. We've shown time and time again that we have talent as is as diverse and as extraordinary as you could possibly imagine. Zach Benson, you can make a school talent show feel like a Red Hot Chili Peppers concert. Lexi and Haley, that 10th grade Peter Pan homecoming hallway was a true thing of beauty. Cade, maybe you shouldn't have let us all know how great of a cook you are, because we might all show up to your house today after this thing is over for lunch. Nikki, Heaven, and Peyton, we may not have made very many pretty things in art, but at least we had fun doing it. Oh, and Jordan, I'll miss you too. I hope that someday you'll learn how to actually pronounce Van Gogh. To anyone else that I haven't mentioned, but should have, it's been a privilege to go through high school with you. The truth is that I'm graduating from a class that I'm proud of, and you all should be too. Overall, the last few years have been a time when we've all found things we're good at, and probably even more things we're bad at. Like I said, our class has seen a lot since we were in eighth grade, and it's hard to believe it's finally drawing to a close. Even though I know most of you can't wait to get your diploma and get out of here, I hope your time here has been great, but that what's to come is better. I hope you'll find everything you're looking for, and maybe even some things you're not. Even though it's been great, don't let high school be the best days of your life. Guys, through all of our different ordinaries that we've come to anticipate, through each of our different friendships, teachers, coaches, principals, exams, field trips, and even the totally normal days that we took for granted, one thing I've come to rely on is seeing all of your faces in the hallway every day. As we say goodbye to high school and say hello to whatever it is that may come next, we're going to have to continue to face the unordinary with grace. In Ecclesiastes 3, we read, "To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance." Today marks the beginning of a new time for us, and I hope you'll all embrace this time with all of its ups, downs, and different ordinaries for us to get used to. Things will be different, but things will be good. As I look at you all, maybe some for the last time, I leave you with the quote on my cap, that you are here, that life exists in identity, that the powerful play goes on, and you may contribute a verse. I can't wait to read your verses. Thank you.
First, Mr. Jacob Baker, please come forward to give the valedictory address.
Good afternoon. Thank you, parents, grandparents, friends, and family, for being here today as we turn the page into the next chapter of our lives. I'm honored to be speaking here today. I make no promises that this speech will be any good, and I apologize if it's long-winded, but I do promise that it will be heartfelt. I'll be honest, as I was thinking about giving this speech, I had no idea what I was going to say. It wasn't really that there wasn't anything to say, but rather that there was far, far more that deserves to be said than I could fit into such a short amount of time. But when I started writing, I kept coming back to one phrase, thank you. So that's what this is going to be, a thank you letter to Castlewood High School. Firstly, I have a few personal things to share. First and foremost, I must thank God for everything he's done for me and for this class. Without him, none of this would be possible, and I know that. I must also thank my parents, for without them, I know for a fact that I would not be speaking to you today as the valedictorian. Mom and Dad, thank you for always pushing me and loving me, even when times were hard. Your influence is what brought me here today, and I love you for that and for so much more. Mom, I'll always love you to the sky and back, and Dad, I'll always love you around the world. Abby, you're not too bad either. I love you, and I wish you the best of luck in high school and beyond. Mama Lois and Papa Ronnie, thank you for being there invariably. No matter what, I'll always be down for a Sunday afternoon trip to Bonanza with you. I know that you'll always be there for me, regardless of anything else, and for that, I am so grateful. The same is true for Granny Helen. Granny, I know that the past few months have been trying, but you're still loving and supportive. I'm eternally grateful for everything you and Papa Daryl have done for me, and especially grateful for the M&Ms that have always been on your table every day I come up. Aside from a supportive family, I have an amazing and wonderful group of friends to thank. Jonah, you've been there as long as anyone. You've came a long way from that chubby, awkward, buck-toothed kid I met in fourth grade. Well, the teeth are still there. Some things never change, I guess. Honestly, though, I don't know what I'd do without you, man. You tell me through more than you ever know. You'll always be my brother. Jonathan and Jordan, you guys have been there just as long. You've never been short on support. Just short. I hope you know that having you by my side through high school, and even before, has meant the world to me. In all seriousness, you through your family, I consider myself lucky to have friends like you. Savannah, the past 2 years have been the best of my life. I know it's a small sample size, but I'm still looking forward to everything that's still to come. I love you with everything in me, and I'm so thankful that you've been able to deal with my annoying self for so long. I hate to tell you this, but you're going to have to deal with me for much longer. Mike and Pam, you're like a second set of parents to me, and you're every bit as supportive as if you were my own. Thank you for raising such an amazing young woman, and thank you for being so wonderful to me. Skylar, you're like another little sister. Thanks for always being able to make me laugh, and continuing to put a smile on my face. Peyton, Cassidy, Jill, Madison, and Cameron, thank you guys for being willing to put up with me for the past few years. I know that wasn't an easy job, and I know sometimes I didn't seem appreciative, but I am. Clay and Cade, you've been there ever since Miss Burt couldn't stand our table in biology. I can honestly say that the performance names that we came up with that year will stick with me forever. Kyle, Trey, Mildrum, Zach, Alex, and Colton. Oh, excuse me, warm butter. I'll never forget the memories on the basketball court or off. Speaking of basketball, thank you, Coach Johnson, for being a great coach, showing us how to be men. And keeping the technicals to a minimum. Miss D, I have so much to thank you for. I don't even know what to say. When I first met you, I never expected to grow so close to such a wonderful, inspiring, and understanding person. You're more than a teacher or a track coach. You're a friend and your family. Thank you for everything. Mr. V and Ashley, thank you for going above and beyond what you required as counselors. No matter how many times I came into your room, you were always welcoming and always helpful. Thanks for making the most stressful and confusing time of our lives a little easier. Miss Lila, I remember in fourth grade when you let Jennifer, Savannah, and me write a play in the hallway during class. And I thank you not only for your support and dedication to the school now, but for everything you did for me way back then. Coach Sparks, Jenna, Patsy, and the rest of the administration, thank you for always being committed to seeing the students of Castlewood High School succeed. To Jay and the custodial staff, thank you for working so hard at what is often a thankless job. Mrs. Hale, Mrs. Marshall, Mrs. Altizer, Mrs. Ramsey, Mr. Burns, Ms. Crabtree, Ms. Allen, Mr. McPherson, Ms. Higgins, Ms. Collins, Mr. Paget, Ms. Debbie, Ms. Renee, Ms. Judy, Ms. Patrick, and every other educator who's helped and influenced me over the years, thank you for always pushing me and believing in me. I'll never be able to repay what you've done. I believe that's it for the people who I need to thank. If I've left anybody out, I truly am sorry. I appreciate the contributions of everyone who's brought me to this point, and I know I wouldn't be here without the people I named and several I didn't. Now, to thank the rest of what has brought the class of 2017 to this point. Thank you to the field, court, or track where so many of us found a second home. You taught us dedication, drive, passion, and teamwork, and were one of the most impactful forces shaping how each one of us turned out. Whether our sport was baseball, volleyball, track, or some combination of other sports, many of us spent the past 5 years committed to our athletics, and because of that commitment, those sports became much more than just another activity. They became part of who we are. Thank you to the stage where many others found solace. You taught us that it doesn't matter where we come from, we're all equal. I shared the stage with band geeks, jocks, brainiacs, and every other manner of label you could stick on a person, and I loved each and every one of them. Each member of the graduating class who's been on the stage feels the same, I'm sure. We're grateful for the opportunity to put those kinds of labels behind and simply enjoy the camaraderie of our castmates. Thank you to the classrooms where we've spent the vast majority of our time in high school. You saw a lot through the years. You saw us at our worst and saw us at our brightest. True, we may have hated your bleak, white walls and uncomfortably small desks, but it's sobering to think that none of us will ever sit in a Castlewood classroom as a student again. I'll never forget the welcoming atmosphere of Miss D's classroom, listening to Jupiter sounds while relaxing in Mr. McPherson's, or jousting with rolly chairs in the lab. As much as I hated sitting confined in the classroom all day, a part of me is always going to miss those four walls. Thank you to the vocational school for showing several of us that education isn't just about math, English, or SOL scores. I was never a part of your programs, but I thank you nonetheless for exposing many members of my class to a system of school that's actually like the real world that people keep telling us about. Thank you to the music that served as the soundtrack of our high school careers. In 20 years, when we look back on all the memories we've made, it seems as if there'll always be a song playing in the background. You know, I'll never forget freestyling to Still Dre in the back of the basketball bus, or the way Cade used to be so into John LeJoie. Thank you to the places where we all hung out. Half of us have probably memorized the menu at El Palenque by now, and at this point, summer's pretty much synonymous with the park. Thank you to Oxbow, Little Stony Falls, Huddle House, and every other place that we managed to find some peace. Living in a small town, it's easy to memorize the roadmap for miles with the amount of time we spent at our hangouts. After high school, that sadly won't be the case for some of us. So I'll forever cherish the good times I had with really good friends. Lastly, and most importantly, thank you to the class of 2017. You guys are the best classmates I could ever ask for. There have been hard times and there have been great times, but you've been good to me and good to each other through it all. Whatever your GPA is, whether you played sports or not, whether you were here every day or whether you were never at school, each and every one of you is important to me, and I love you all, and I'm proud of each and every one of you. You've been kind, inspiring, thoughtful, and more than anything, you have been my friends. I'll never let go of the memories we made, laughs we shared, jokes we told, or time we spent together. I'll miss a lot about high school, but I'll miss you guys the most. There isn't a group of people on earth whom I'd rather graduate with today, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. It's been an honor to be your classmate. It's been an even greater honor to be your friend. I wish you all nothing but the best in everything that you go on to do. Thank you so much.
At this time, if Dr. Brown, the Russell County School Board members, will please join me in front of the podium, and Mr. Sparks would please come forward, we will begin awarding the diplomas.
Jacob McKenzie Baker. Savannah Jade Robertson. Cameron Grace Cook. Jillian Margaret Shepherd. Madison Lane Ray. Noah Cade Steele. Morgan Chantel Wallace. Allison Brooke Skeens.
Go,
Allison Paige Long. Shelby Jean Grizzle. Cassidy Grace Fleming. Peyton Alexis Michelle Jesse. Cody Vaughn Mead. Sydney Marie Strange. Darla Brianne Mullins. Nicholas Dwayne Tittle. Grayson Jane Wright. Brittany Dawn Williams. Lindsay Noel Taylor. Autumn Rochella Hall. Cassandra Leanne Salyer. Sage Morgan Finch. Nikki Summer Kennedy. Lauren Elizabeth Phillips. Heaven Lee Hofield. Michael Clay Turner. Haley Brooke Duty. Tori Alexis Monk. Austin Blake Hamilton. Christopher Trey Phillips. Annie Ruth Woods. Lakin Alyssa Shea Mullins. Derek Brandon Phipps. Stephen Dakota Deal. Colton Blake Long. Christian Kyle Kennedy. Jacob Lewis Neil Keith. Nathaniel Trey Lopez. Dylan Bryant Phipps. Zachary Levi Lowe. Dylan Wade Bush. David Seth Minton. Morgan Chance Burton. Patrick Dwayne Turner. Seth Allen Wilson. Jody Lynn Boyd. Caitlin Brianne Dingus. Angelina Nicole Mullins. Zachary Paul Gene Vinson. Walker Dwayne Reiner. Trevor Douglas Engel. Dallas Jeffrey Engel. Christopher Noah Fields. Jeffrey Dalton Baker. Tia Marie Pennington. Jose Roberto Martinez. Zachary Lewis Travers. Justin Taylor Smallwood. Ronald Lee Salyers. Keith Tyler Lee Snipes. Thomas Lee Threet. Jamie Caleb Kaiser. Ashley Rebecca Bellamy. Ashley Victoria Glover. Samantha Carol Jackson. Anthony Carol Jackson. Devin Blake Phillips. Cody Wayne Ambergy. Sean Tyler Breeding. Hunter Chase Lowe. Brandon Michael Helton. Danielle Shante Ball. Kimberly Brianna Nicole Niece. Dakota Wayne Skeens. Deanna Michelle Duncan. Jared Michael Engel. Sean Michael Long. Roy Lee Mabry Jr. Cody Franklin Jordan.
At this time, if Jillian would come to start the video, and would everyone please adjust your seating so you'll be able to view the senior class video on the wall behind the podium.
Thank you.
Congratulations to our seniors. Graduates, again, I commend you for your diligence, effort, and determination. It is my pleasure and honor as principal, by the power vested in me by the Russell County School Board and the Commonwealth of Virginia, to declare you graduates of Castlewood High School. Everyone, please stand for the recessional and remain at your seats until our graduates, faculty, and guests have left the gymnasium.
Thank you.